Fiddles and jelly spoons, bugs and grubs, potatoes of all ages, it's time for a stream. It's time for the Wizard of Oz. Do you know what? We're not even going to do an intro. We're going to dive straight in and we're going to play some football. Because I'm in the mood. How are we doing, folks? I cut off the video. I've never done that before. We're changing it up. We're going wild. We're going crazy. I'm on the wrong screen. In here. Am I unmuted? Yes. Just checking. It's a very me thing to do. How's everybody going? I went to the football last night for the first time in over 10 years. I went to an A-League game, Adelaide United versus Central Coast Mariners. Adelaide United, where we started this very save, the Wizard of Oz. We lost 2-1. It was very sad. But I got to see hero of the stream, Destry Irukunda play. A couple of scary moments where we thought he was seriously injured, but he was fine. But yeah, it was a good game. Just Adelaide scored in like the first 3 minutes from a penalty. We got into the ground, sat down, penalty, goal, bang. Call as you like it. Craig Goodwin, another hero of the save, nailed the penalty. It was great. And then Adelaide just went completely missing in the first half. Conceded a goal and they were pretty much done. And Goodwin didn't play well for the rest of the game. Wayward passing and giving up a lot of possession. It was very sad. Anyway, we're not here to talk about Adelaide United. That part of our history is done. We're here to talk about Newcastle United in the Premier League. I was going to say Premiership, it's Premier League, where we're playing. We're currently seventh in the league. We're losing ground with the teams above us. Crystal Palace, for example, who also have a game in hand on us, which is a bit rubbish. Because we've had very ropey form. Competitions-wise, we're still in the Prem. Obviously, we'll be there all season. We're still in the Champions League. We're in ninth. We've still a chance for sneaking through and qualifying up here, but we need to win our remaining games, basically, and win them convincingly because our goal difference isn't great. We're in the FA Cup. We got knocked out of the Carabao Cup. Next up, we face Leicester at home. Hopefully, we can get a win because it's been very, very spotty. We got off to a pretty good start at the beginning of the season. I believe we were top of the table at one point. And then it's all just gone pear-shaped massively. Throughout a lot of this run, we didn't have our striker, Norberto Hoss. And we've been pretty ravaged with injuries. So at the moment, we've got Panikaitis out. He's out for 3 weeks. He's our right back. A young winger, Vale, who was doing all right before the injury. He's still out for over a month. And Vika, our young superstar midfielder, he's out for another 3 weeks. So it's pretty bare bones at the moment. And I've picked a squad here for the Leicester game that hopefully can get the job done. But our defence has been in really poor form. And you can see here from the ratings, Springzig's dropped to a 6.6. And he was outstanding earlier in the season. Hoxha, he's a backup at best, is one of our best performers. Della Basic recently, over the last 5 games, has been kind of the standout, which is really weird. Silva's been playing for the Rezzies, so that doesn't count. Petrosko's dropped right off the boil for a 6.5. Like, it's just very, very ordinary in terms of what we've been producing. And that's part of why I just want to dive in and play. Transfer window opens same day as this game. We don't have a lot of money, but we do have a couple of expensive players wage-wise on the way out. So that'll let us adjust some funds and move that into transfer budget. Maybe enough to make a purchase. Given the state of the squad, I'm not 100% sure about moving anybody on, just because I don't know if we'll be able to replace them. But Silva, Antonio Silva, who was going to be a good signing and it never really panned out, he's on his way out, as is Yasser Asprilli. He's an icon of the club, but yeah, he was very, very expensive and he just needs to go. We're said to be interested in signing Dante Gervin, which I am, because he'd be great on the left wing, and he's not that expensive. Lucas Rodriguez, he's a left back, he's too old, and Tottenham are talking about a rubbish bid, Fogden, and Fogden hasn't been super convincing of late either, so... Yeah, I'm hoping tonight we can turn the form around, but the real focus at the moment is going to be on the Champions League. That's kind of our priority this season. All right, so that unhappy that Esprit is gone. They're unhappy that Silver's gone. They've both gone to Ajax. But yeah, they're out the door. Gonski, Dunski, au revoir. And that should help minimize some disruption. Star player, that's fine. We'll get into Stain. It's our mentoring groups. Is that a promise that I've made him? Do I need to adjust his No, I'd say it's just his squad status. He's updated. Star player. There we go. So more game time for Vykett, I'm fine with that. But I'm certainly not letting go for 26 million. That is madness. I've remembered to turn the ticker on, so that's new. A couple of loan players back that we're not gonna use. Right, so if we look at the finances now, we've got another half of a mil or so. Cool. And who's wanted? Delabasic is wanted by West Ham. Osborne's wanted for loan, which I'm not overly keen to do. Borac is wanted by PSG. Bailey's wanted by Chelsea and PSG. Chelsea and Tottenham. So clubs are interested in a few of our players. We can't really afford to sell any that are from England, and that's the other thing. We're going to have to pay the premium for English-based players because of Champions League registration. Otherwise, more players are going to have to miss out, and that is no good for us at all. So the board were down to a B minus, supporters were down to a C plus. That's 20, he's pretty good. Still got potential to improve. I'm tempted to go in for him. It's not English though. He's under 21. It's tempting. He's tempting. Definitely need more money before we pull the trigger on anything. Alright, well for starters, let's see if we can go and get a result against Leicester. I've rotated a little bit. Let's put Saka in the squad. It's fine. We want to start with a win. Well, that's no guarantee of a good stream. We started with a win last time out. Yesterday morning. And didn't do us a hell of a lot of good. More pressure on the players, because I'm a pressure monster. Come on, we need to get a result, guys. We need to turn around this crap form. Comfy, with microphones, you can hear me. And we're off to the races. I've tweaked the tactic a little bit. We've reverted to the low block to try and cut out some of these silly goals. We've got a corner. Sousa launches into the area. We're up in the air. That looks like that's a penalty. Applethwaite, the offender. I'm not quite sure what happened there because there's nothing really off to my eye. But penalty it is, and it should be Hoss stepping up to take. Get him back in the goals. That'll be handy. Come on, Hoss. You can do it. And do what he does. First goal of the stream. We're up and running, kids. Trumpets ahoy! We did a football goal. Yay! Allah. yeah, let's not kick the crap out of them anymore if we're picking up yellow cards already. Finds more. Everyone seems happy with that. And for the last 10 minutes of this half, we're going to switch to positive. Try and get more of the ball, which hasn't really worked. We've got another corner. It's Werner, launches it in. We're up in the air. Oh, nearly from Hoxha. Hoxha. That's how it's spelt. Keep it simple. All right. Doing well, can definitely improve. Also, Delabasic is playing it right back, and surprise, surprise, not having a great day. No one is really. Alright. Bring in the changes. Sergio's coming on the left. On the right. That'll do for now. Lester have got the football. I don't care for this at all. They're moving it around far too easily. They're going to find a killer ball in a minute. I can feel it coming. No, not like this. I'm gonna get punished for not capitalizing on all these chances! All season, I've been doing that all season. All over the top. Sprinter wasn't awake to it. Poor attempt at a save from Fogden, just... Here they come again. Hoss is tired. So he's going to come off for Perry Osborne. Why not? Bailey's just been poor. Sousa plays it all the way back with a very weird pass to Sprinzing. All over the top, back to Sousa, and he scores. Pretty much does it all himself. That is his 8th goal of the season. Well spotted from Sprinzing with the run. And then Sousa off the side of his boot sends the ball home. And now we've got to try and protect the lead, which is not our forte. We're just letting this guy saunter in, easy as light. Here's Osborne now, trying to do something useful. Sergio, back to Osborne. He's found a pocket of space to run into. Plays it across to Sergio. That is really well worked. Good vision from Osborne. Good run from Sergio. And that gives us a 2-goal advantage with 15 minutes in normal time to play. Well done, Terry Osborne. He just kept running and running and running. Sergio got away from his defender, just found a beautiful little pocket of space. Easy tap in. Well done, lads. Do we have one more change we can make? We do, and guys around. I'll throw on Delacorte for Caesar. I'll let Coutinho play on. So some very inexperienced players up front now. But Petrusco shows his class and cuts that out. Much better performance from him, playing well out of position. Now they're looking to hit us on the break. Can we get the ball back? No. Lost all the way back to the keeper, but now they're looking to move it forward very quickly. Oh, Delacorte, nearly. He would have been away there. Oh, that's unfortunate. It's clever work to try for the interception there. Coutinho, he's got support in Sergio. Bursts into the area. Chips the keeper. It's cleared off the line. Sergio's won the rebound. Osborne gets up there to challenge that loose ball. That was intense for a minute. I mean, we've actually worked hard in the second half and it paid dividends. That's a win. You did well. Santiana actually had a decent game. It's a miracle. Player of the game is Terry Osborne. The young apprentice striker. He's actually improved half a star's worth. It's a really important win for morale, for league position, for a whole bunch of reasons. We're going to have to pay Porto $3 million. Sergio. Hey, Lucas is in. Welcome along. He's been popping up for years. Press conference, because we won a football game. No comment on positions that we want to strengthen. Cool. Two steps, bridge your leg. Oh no, dude. Sorry to do that. Watch the Lakers get butchered in game 5. Stop the Rose game 6. Heard about that. Also watch KK. Nice. I watched a couple of movies today too. Legs alright, look after it. Get some ice on it. Or heat, ice and heat. Keep the blood circulating. Help it heal up. And maybe some Nurofen gel if it's really sore. That will help. Cocaine Bear I haven't seen yet, but there was a couple of movies on my radar I wanted to check out. One of them was The Northman. If you haven't seen that, here's a quick review. It's beautifully shot nonsense. If you want to watch a movie about Vikings and revenge plot, just watch the show Vikings. A million times better. You don't need to see that movie. It's not very good. The other thing I watched today, because I just had a super lazy day, was Everything Everywhere All at Once. And if you haven't seen that, and most people have, but if you haven't, and I hadn't, it is friggin' brilliant. It's an excellent movie. It's like everything you wanted Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness to be that it wasn't. It did a multiverse movie way better than Doctor Strange. And I love Doctor Strange, don't get me wrong. But yeah, really, really good movie. Really interesting and so well done. Michelle Yeoh was amazing. Keke Han, I can see why you got an Academy Award. That was amazing. Such a good movie. 2 and a bit hours. It's a little bit slow in spots, but it's slow for a reason, and it works. I'm not going to accept a deal where you don't pay anything. Where does he want to go? Says what's your problem? These ones for no money aren't an option.
You say you only wanna be best friends. I just wanna be a damn girlfriend. What I gotta do to make you face the truth?
And Port Vale can do one. Oh, and Peterborough can do one as well. Just the clubs who are offering money. Thank you very much. I haven't been to see Guardians 3 yet. I was going to go today, but I couldn't be bothered. I haven't left the house today. I was so lazy. But I'll go see Guardians this week. What Oscars were you watching? If you think Cocaine Bear won all the Oscars, the bear's not the only one doing junk. Cut the dose. Why would I arrest him? Have we got time to play a friendly, or is this an international break? It always feels good to be honest. Can't you admit that you where would we slot one? Everybody knows it except for you. It's not really worth it. We'll just... This combo kind of works. I'm not against it. Some of these guys seriously need to lift their game, or I will sell them. 8 million silly dollars at bottom. This is very true. I'm kind of glad it didn't make like all the money, Cocaine Bear. It's going to consider his options. He's going to crack it because he's not playing, but he's injured. Leafs lost in game 5. Yeah. Oh, the Leafs. What are we going to do with those guys? What? Right. We're going to rotate pretty hard here. Sergio is going to start on the right. So Osborne up front. Sprinting. No, we're going to leave Bailey there. Yep. Basically, all we're looking for is to get a performance out of the guys who have been really poor. And give everyone else a bit of a breather. Blue jacket. That's the spirit. You gotta stay positive. Make it so, number one. So what happens if I offer Della Bassett chat? Ah, no, 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 no. He don't want to go anywhere. And we're definitely going to need a player trained in England. There's no English nationality. Dear, dear. Look how much money we'd need to do this. Plays left and right wing, so that's a problem because you get in the way of the other dudes. This guy can play defensive mid, but he's 33. Another right winger. This guy can play left back. He's 30. Expensive. I guess we can bring in some loans just for squad reg. There's no good loan options around either. Get my players for free, guys. It's just not a thing. You want them, you pay money. Striker. It's really maybe left mid, defensive mid, or a defender. That's kind of actually good now. Yeah, diminishing returns down here. Who I just wouldn't trust. So we're stuck looking at this sort of biz. We can't afford. See the damage you're making, sure and faking it. Scout Gary Preston. Scout this guy as well. And again, once we get down here, it's... We'll see what that turns up. So we can do... it's weird. We haven't really had a transfer window here at Newcastle without having money. And even the ones who are rumoured, like Delibasic and co, no one's putting in an offer for them with the form they've been in. They've been terrible. And I just don't know how to turn it around. Send me an email. Moving on. We've got a while till this Grimsby game. I just don't know that we're going to be able to do any business because I don't really want to add more in terms of transfer debt. Apparently someone's interested in the takeover again. What are the odds? I mean, if that progresses and we go in an embargo, got anyone good? Please don't help us at this point. We need Englishmen. Matches are going to be on the tally. Look at that. A bunch of clauses. How much money can we get in on clauses? Boule. There's about 10 million there. 600 grand, it's not worth it. Loman. 3.3 million. Doubt he's playing for them at the moment. Armin, 4.6. 10. 13. Let's call it 17. Tack that onto what we've already got. 35. 40 mil. just me. Cinemax there. And suggest me Cinemax online. Remember him? You're not English. Phil James. Not that Phil James, is it? Nah, different Phil James. Good to know, just checking. I just don't have the money to do anything worthwhile. Don's just not offering enough money, mate. Having no money in a transfer window sucks. Sucks massively. Just can't do anything. I mean, maybe. Maybe a player exchange type deal for someone that we actually, you know, want. Now you, See what happens. They won't take it. It's, he's got one of these crazy, crazy transfer values going on. But you know, he sent Delibasic home to Bayern, where we got him from. That's probably part of the problem, actually, now that I think about it. They know the money they got for him was an absolute criminal act. They saw me coming. See, Ambrosino, again, would be an amazing signing. Sure, get a Bradford City. I'm not going to praise the 7.1 because we'll get a Grumpy on. So we've made one transfer offer and it's a bit rubbish and there's no way they're taking it. If the club get taken over and someone to just throw like 800 million into the transfer budget and I'll go crazy. We'll buy our Champions League win. Yeah, I didn't think so. What's all of these? Optional transfers in 30, 40 million pound range for this kid. It's not that good. Moving on, moving on, moving on. Cheers, everybody. Hillsborough is still knocking around the place, taking the reins in Aston Villa. Ball bugger. Stop looking at him, DP. It's not going to help you. It's not going to help you at all. This guy could, but I don't want to commit to spending 30 odd million on a 24-year-old. Ordinary centre back. Afford to do anything. Very frustrated. Stupid agents like that. I don't know what we're gonna do. Let's hope some of these Rotated players put on a bit of a show in the FA Cup against Grimsby Town. And somehow we get some decent offers in. We've got to bring in a British player before the end of the window. That's not negotiable. Whether we get desperate or just have a random loan, which won't have a mandatory future fee attached to it. We got burned on that last time with what's-his-face. Lima. It's a bad deal. Shafted on that one royally. Come on, game. You can do it. £7 million. He's dumb. Game's becoming impossible. Is Bill A still playing? Yes. On the regs. Not English, no point. I just found that interesting that he was actually available for loan, but he probably wouldn't come back anyway. So the clause on this guy is 28. Very much gummed up. It is a tough spot to be in at the moment. We'll figure it out. It's going to be fine. Robert's halfway through the window. I haven't bought anybody. Feels weird. Easy win predicted for us. Well, we'll see about that. With our recent efforts, don't you worry. I'm sure Grimsby will give us a bloody run for our money. But we did win the first game of the stream. Everyone should be well rested. They've had a good breather. Fit. Pancardis is 7 days away from fitness. Bike it. 5 to 10 days. Bali is still out for a month, though. Why Sergio dropped down so hard? Right, we are going to seriously criticize the form. Your form's been crap. See, worn, recent form. Play to a high standard. Right, that'll do. Everyone needs to have a talking to. He's had a talking to. If it works or not, it's a different story. Chelsea drew with Oldham. Good job, Oldham. So we got Grimsby, Everton, and then Hertha in Champions League. And then apparently the hardest team made a defeat in Football Manager 23. Frickin' Leeds. Here we go. We played one game and gone for an hour. Is that right? Doesn't seem right. Someone's going in for this kid. I don't know why. Probably because he's good and we should get in on the action. But again, I don't want to be jagged up. For another 30 million quid player that I don't actually want. Let's go play a football game, because it's that time. We're already there. Came out of nowhere for me. It's the scene. Let's get into it. Want to get another win. That'll be two on the bounce, bit of momentum, undo the damage that those losses did. And hopefully, Cherry Osborne can have a good game. This is sort of his level. Look, not only do they not have corners, they don't even have real stands here in Grimsby Town. I can't believe we're doing a National League team. But we are away from home, so. Come on, guys, it's been 10 minutes. Time for a goal. Jeez Louise. First attacking highlight is for Grimsby. Got a corner. Osborne launches it in. That's a poor corner. A nothing attack. Not our finest work. Oh my god, we're gonna get done with the long ball. You guys pull your bloody digits out, please. This is poor. Launch a freak. What the hell is Santiniano doing there? There was nobody in a blue shirt anywhere near where he put that ball. What an Ass clown. Oh God. You got 10 minutes, Osborne. Sort your life out. I think it's a shot on target, but very easy for the keeper. Telebasic nearly got done by a National League winger there. So, you know, we found his level. Non-league. Who was that? Horak. Okay, all the way back to Delabasic. Like, I don't want to have to do this, but I'm going to have to bring on the big guns because everybody else is screwing the pooch. I'll say big guns, I'll throw in Della Corte on, but Santiniana scored. I've got to play the trumpets for Santiniana. It's been our worst player all season. He scored the worst goal all season. Striklers. We're 1-0 up against Grimsby. This has been not a very convincing performance at all. What is your role? Fullback on attack. Wolves had way too much of the ball in this game and I don't like it. Can we play the ball forward, please? There we go. Eddie Sergio gets his 7th goal of the season. A little bit more respectability to the scoreline. I mean, we're winning. I should be more excited. But this is a National League team. And we haven't exactly set the world on fire in this game. It's been pretty ordinary.
Oh,
We could have been more aggressive from the kickoff, I guess. We could have played with a more attacking mentality or whatever. But the point was, the guys who haven't been having a good season, to get out there, rip a team apart, and just grab a huge chunk of confidence moving forward. And we've not done that. They've just coasted. Santillana's just played one of the worst freaking balls forward I've ever seen. He's got a goal, so his rating's artificially inflated, but he's not worth an 8.2 today. There's no way. Guys, we came off the bench, played 30 minutes, were up there as highest ratings, pretty telling. Can't believe I just had to have a chat with Santillana. Two ball playing defenders.
I could sit around and wait all day.
Better. Must be fit again. We need.
I don't want to waste it on anybody. Take it with anybody but you.
Criticize the form. A lot. But two wins on the bounce. Let's make it 3 in a row against Everton, who last time we played, if I'm not mistaken, we absolutely decimated. 7-1 at home. Who's Ben? When you slash striker, you want to spend my whole transfer budget on him. He's 28. He's having a great season. What's the bet? That's what I want to check on this guy. His eligibility. If he's not English, there's no point. He's not an option. Cancel the transfer offer. Walk away, don't want him. 23.5 million for a player I probably can't register. English only, director of football. If anything, he should be more on top of that scenario than I am. Don't spend money before we brought any in. It's not going to help. Ah, he's just got the job at Leipzig. How? Didn't he get sacked? Crazy. You're not good enough. You're definitely not good enough to come in and help us out. You don't play in a position that I need. And you're not good enough. Listed, but I can't afford him. The other guy, if I sold all these, if I sold all the transfer thingy bobs clauses, that's what I was looking for, got there. Sold all those transfer clauses, I can afford that Daniele, but he's not English. So again, it doesn't help. And there's no way I'm getting a half decent English player for under 40 million. They don't exist. Expensive mid, 43 to 64, but they're not going to take installments. Plus he's 24, he's never going to get any better than he is right now. And we've had him before. Look at that. And the rest is these guys who aren't great value at all. Why would I buy a player from Everton who are in 18th place? Maybe you can feel the pressure that I've been living on. So this guy's been at Tottenham, wasn't very good, Bayer, wasn't very good, Barcelona, and was ordinary.
Yeah.
Don't, it's cheap. Come in and do a job, I guess. He's not up to snuff. But he's cheap. I could do a bit of mentoring, I guess. Maybe you can feel the pressure that I've been living on. I can say that it's been on my mind, but I'm moving along. To judge in a canon for this, yeah. Offered him 100 grand a week for a year. And he'd just be coming in to help out with the registration. So all up, with the sign-on fee, it's like 2 million, which is next to nothing. He'd be crazy not to take the deal. He's not going to play for us. But it's a bargain. It replaces Asprey's role, which is to make up the numbers in squad registration for Europe. We still don't have enough young players trained at club. But it gets us back up to that 8 level, so that's something, I guess. Thought I said you couldn't go to them for... going a bit wrong. I wanna live your life. I wanna dream your dreams. Lick the moon. Knowles, who's Knowles? Tom Knowles. Is that little jerk memory serves? Shut off, it doesn't. I mean, you're not ready to come back in the team, Panicardus. Why are you even... No, it's fine. What am I responding to? What do I have to respond to? Oh, press on. Okay, that makes sense. Story checks out. I'll allow it. There we go, we're done. Alright, before we play Everton, we're going to take a breather. I'm going to go to the bathroom. Do all that stuff. So everybody get up. Take a walk. Stretch your legs. Stretch your cables. Smoke if you've got them. And we'll be back in a few minutes. Take on... Le Toffees, Danny Bilbao. I remember paying money for him a while back. No, he came through the youth setup. He's never going to be any good. And they're offering 6.5 million. So, yep. We're running out of mentoring groups here. Sergio's on the improve. Nice. Nice, 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 nice. Yeah, they got that kick from United. But they're going to be stuck with him forever. Training praise. Super quick, and then we're going to take this breather. Yeah. I do the same, I'm a sinner. One thing I want to check really quick, or a couple of things actually. Bernard, what are you training to do? So training final third. Okay, that's fine. Bailey, what are you training to do? Anchor, no more. Train. Plays defensive midfielder on support. Right. Ah, looking at hero of the stream. He's retiring at the end of the season. I say hero of the stream. It was the most expensive transfer we made in the beta. And he's ordinary. Blaine. Friend of the stream. Back to mine. Man City signed a cow. And we're bringing in this old man. We got our grandpa. Bailey, welcome to the squad. Give him a squad number. Request me on Facebook, no, I ain't adding them. Positions I had her in. Hit from the back, that pussy just splattering. Call up a friend. Hey, we're back at the 8. Make it a gathering. They love that baby. Nah, I'm Matic now, but she loving the splash again. I just be cashing in her buns, just like a wedding. I'm crashing. Ah, come on. She want to cut up, I'm a slash again. Buckets on buckets, I'm switching and dishing back in my back, going back again. I feel like Aladdin, yeah. I'm on a carpet flying through orbits, ain't doing no talking. Okay, break time. Back soon. Don't go anywhere. I know if you did. Loving the drip, think I'm a force, it got me cautious. Back in my duffel, I'm working a double like I'm in the office. Telling to watch it. Now I ain't talking my pockets, just no we ain't running out the way that we stock it. If I got it, you got it. If I call it, she slide and tell her to mop it. Yeah, I got that shit doing. Then she took that thing off and bring it around. Going at it till I'm on. Put that nani in a hole, I'm beating it down. I'm back in that bag again. Whoa, whoa. Oh, say less. I'm back in that bag again. Yeah, yeah. Oh, say less. I'm back in that. Yeah. What you doing? Yeah, yeah. I'm back in that. Hey. Where you gone? And you should know that we on this forever. You don't know me well, just ask again. And you should know that I'm with all the fuckery. Why you sit down and just watch the film? And you should know that Khan got a bottle of Don, feeling like Julio, pass it in. Mine on some M's, going in. Back in that bag where I'm going again.
I'm dunking on them, just lower the rim. Free my niggas, it's all in a pen. I hit it once, I'ma hit it again. She with me, you know she a 10. She a Barbie, you know I'm a Ken. Rolling some dope, and sipping some gin. It's always been us, it never was them. Back in my bag, they know it's a gem.
Tell them to watch it. Now I ain't talking my pockets, just know we ain't running out the way that we stock. If I got it, you got it. If I call it, she slide and tell her to mop it. Yeah, I got that shit doing. Then she took that thing off and bring it around. Going at it till I'm on. Put that nani in a hole, I'm beating it down. I'm back in that bag again. Whoa, whoa. Oh, say less. I'm back in that bag again. Yeah, yeah. Oh, say less. I'm back in that. Yeah. What you doing? Yeah, yeah. I'm back in that. Hey. Where you going? Hey.
Hey, we're back. Let's go play some football, shall we? Up on Strux, done. That's all fine. Let's go. I need to change an instruction. really do. This match should be winning. Do it. Defenders, strong defense. Midfielders, do that. Quality finishing. Sano! Look. Kick it off. The first thing we're going to do is make a tweak right here. And that's fine because they're inverted wingers. That's right. Cancel. We're fine. Encourage the boys. Because we're away from home. It's nearly always horrible. We just won a good game. Murdo, what are you doing? Just running into traffic. He's stolen the football and we've given it straight back again. Pulled out of position there. The problem with the low back block is getting run ragged. Ooh, Hoss nearly made the interception there. Pass a lot, but they're not actually doing anything. Now they're through. Here it comes. Just cut through us like butter. Goal awarded. Nope, disallowed. Okay. I'm still not happy with our work there. No one was awake to it. Let's see if we can take a lead. Trusco's hit the bar. Really not happy. Good pass from Petroske. Hoss was lurking. Switching Hoss to a complete forward. We're not really playing direct enough for an advanced forward. I was thinking about this the other night after the stream when, you know, I should have been doing other stuff. A bit better. Hoss has done well there. Stolen ball away. Werner's a bit jammed up. Hoss has made a run, but he's well offside. Why is he even celebrating? You know you were offside, dude. All day. Miles off. I've told them to stop going into the tackle hard because we've picked up two yellow cards for Bailey and Patino. That we could do without. Done there. Done like a dog's dinner. Hoss has come deep. Sousa gets away from his man. He's got support, sort of. Hoss just taking a pot shot. Let's wait the ball in the box. Maybe with that low block, we need to be passing more direct. Thank you. Yep. Let's try that. This is better. It's more promising. We've won a corner. Susa, take, should be near post, it is, 10 your heads over, it's always moving away from goal. Wayne has seen a lot of ball, Susa's kind of not, Boss is in, oh, straight at the keeper. Gonna be a crap draw, isn't it? 20 minutes ago, Seuss is not working for us. Sergio's gonna come on for him. What else isn't working? Dangerous. Launched it forward. Looking for the winger, and we couldn't find him. No! Oh! Lose. I don't want to see filthy replay. Oh my God, what was that? They've completely lost the plot here. Here comes number two. Sergio takes it wide. And just passes it casually back to the opposition. Brilliant. When did we forget how to play any kind of attack? Don't pass it. He's offside by a million miles. Why are you giving him the ball? These idiots are going to get me fired. I have no ideas on how to fix this inconsistency and how crap we are. Getting really, you might have noticed, I'm getting really frustrated with this pack of clowns. It's legitimately infuriating at this point. That loss cost us £3 million. And more. Another game we absolutely should have won, and we just roll over and let them tickle our bellies. Changing the shape for the next game. Change tactic for the Hertz game. It's probably dumb, but it's a must win. Something's got to give. It's not a huge switch. We're just dropping the defensive midfielder because Bailey's been crap. And we're going with an attacking mid. Like this. $61 million for Bogdan. But I can't replace him, no. Really don't want to offer any contract either. Oh, It's all gone wrong. What jobs are on offer? Lesser or evident. If any of the gigs come up at the big clubs, we're absolutely taking it. We're gonna go for it. We can't stay here forever. I was hoping we could. These places started out so well. They're getting worse. And I don't know why. There's no real reason for it. Team bonding, because I suspect we're going to need it for dynamically purposes. Well, that didn't go well. Just lost the dressing room, everybody. Now we're going to lose against Hertha. Every time this takeover is rumoured, we go into a crap drop of form, and that's got to be the reason why it hasn't happened. It keeps coming up. We freaking need it, because we need the influx of cash. We need this guy, a good defensive midfielder, and it's not happening. Game. We've got to win every game. It's more a case at the moment, we've got to win this game to undo the damage I did. Botching the team talk. Man. I remember when this game used to be fun. Those were the days. Why is Petrusco gone so far off the boil this season? We're 11th now in the Champions League. We have to win this game. These transfer values. Do you believe in magic? Is it our scouts? Is it the coaching staff? Do you believe in magic? It's just bad freaking attitude. Unto the things you do.
6, finding bliss when you're drunk or you're doing drugs. When you're drunk, when you're drunk, when you're drunk, when you're drunk.
That's all I can pick, it's fine.
7, 8, feeling brave, but you never really play this game.
Of course, Bailey's unhappy about playing out of position. I don't care. Where did I put him? Is he up on the wing or something stupid? What have I done? Oh, idiot. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Do something, do something, do something, do something. Right, good football. First attacking highlight of the game. Ball's with us. Pass. Wayward shot. And someone was offside. Place for comfort. Come on, guys.
Me too, I'm just like you, and I need to fuck it up sometime. I'm stuck with ego trips and sex to a mother will buy. Sometimes I feel magic and I manage to fuck up somehow.
Okay, this is it. We're going to get a goal here. And then we're going to be able to go on with it. It'd be great. That's my plan. Kicking the crap out of us in our own area here. Left back I actually wanted. He was capable of playing well. This is a long highlight, which is always terrifying. Ball to Haas is in, and he's got the flag. He's up. This song, it's rubbish. What is going on? Nah. Come on now. Hey, Petrosko just brought him on. And with a header, puts us in front. But a much needed goal. Boys are still partying. Settle down, lads. One more change I can make here. Gotta throw it. Santiana actually threw it to one of our players and then has immediately just passed it to one of theirs. And Vikings just stood there and given the ball away. They're gonna. Oh, Santiana's made a great run to get back in cover. I know Vikings not fully fit, but come on, man. Oh, that was a hospital pass and a half. That's it. Launch it forward. Win the ball. That's it. Sergio, run. Get it to Hoss. Get it to Hoss. He's in the center. He's there for you. Oh! She's gone off the boil again. Oh, they've got the football and there's still like 2 minutes of injury time. Not like this. He's offside. They're going to make us watch all of this last minute too, aren't they? The monsters. Anna, what are you doing, you f***ing clown? Based on what I've seen in the match engine, and I can't believe I'm saying this, but based on what I've seen in the match engine, I'm not saying that, I'm going to jinx. Fucking hell, ref. I'll say it at full time. But the match ratings are lying massively. Santillana was actually the best player on the pitch. Petrosco's got an 8.2 because he scored a goal, but Werner, for me, does not deserve a 7, and Vikert does deserve 7.1. No one was under a 6-5. I'm not going to dish out any fines. And I mean, the fines aren't working, so it doesn't matter anyway. That moves us into 7th place. And we've secured at least a playoff spot. $2 million for that. Just glad Petrosco actually had a good game. We've got Cardiff in the 4th round of the Cup. A championship team. So we'll probably lose. Everybody's getting a day off. Go back to this. I'm gonna go shorter passing, slower tempo, work the ball into the box. Aus is going to play as a complete forward on attack. Why the B set as a regista? Oh, because it's Horak. See everyone's out in a couple of days. It's no use to me. I mean, you would be. It'd be great. Let's go lose the lead. Leads are one of our bogey teams where we've just been perpetually unable to get a result when we need one. I believe, yep, last time we went from 7-1 win against Everton to a 2-0 loss at home to freaking Leeds. You could call me filthy, I'm only as a watchy. And watch, look at Chris, I see the owner who's injured. LAX touchdown, I ain't sleeping a beat. Sleep on a beach, Santa Monica, total catchy. Nana Jigarji, I got a lot of things on my mind, man. Haji, you are the suckers playing games. I've been doing all Gio got to ins and put into a song. Stupid long, get in the car, chill on chill. Rodeo your driving, Sonny, we be riding. Top down, cruising down, freeway vibing. See, what I'd really appreciate at this point is for the AI to pop up with, like, hey, you know what you could do? Speak to team, try this. Pretty useful. I
I've been dreaming about this ever since day one. I was young, all this hurt that was to J1 and done. Talk about the money, nigga, bought a tongue. Put it up, she talk about my name, one nigga, bought a tongue. Dreaming of a brighter day, you know I had to dim the sun. Hopping off of that brand new pants. Okay, now no new friends. When I'm a god that I'm innocent.
Let's go. Palace is still in fourth, and we're languishing down. Where the hell are we in the league? Seventh. Disgusting. We have to beat PSG. We're going to drop into those stupid playoff spots, which I definitely don't want. We don't need to be playing any more football at the moment. Okay. Hey, Galactic Flowers. Welcome along. We are just about to play Everton. To make it. Is it three wins on the bounce? Did we lose one? I can't even remember. We just won a Champions League game against her today. And the last time we played Leeds, they beat us 2-0. At home. At St. James's Park, we're managing Newcastle United. So we definitely don't want a repeat of that. Yep. Run the attack, which I hate. Yikes. With my arms, so they're all over us early. For you to find me. We've got a corner. Sousa. Oh, so Giannis has just gone just wide. Casual ass again. Keep the morale up. Ball aiming for, I think, either Werner or Hoss. It got to neither. And now they're just passing around us as if we aren't there. No! Bogdan, you... Leeds! We can't play against Leeds! And Delibasic both just massively drop on the ball. We berate them. Get it in. It's in. Flag is down. It's goal for Petrosco. Don't even think about disallowing it, ref. That goal counts. We've equalised and we're going to go on and win the game. That's how this works. That's what we need to have happen right here. Yes! Milos Petrosko just launches it at the top of the net and says, get stuffed. Encourage the boys. Momentum swinging back our way. That's a good ball. Out to Vernet. He's got space in the centre. Sousa, oh, why didn't you chase it and just tap it in? And why you want a 6.3? K
get out the way. Who got a watch? Who got the time? I'm raising the clock. Even in my feelings, grind don't stop. Got big dreams, want big rocks. I got plans, you got talk. That is real cheap, but it's really cold house. I'm trying to get these ends. Building buyers with my friends.
Alright, second half. You're getting the demand more straight away. Don't leave him open. That's it. Tenye steals it. Has a run. He's got Haas ahead of him. Finds him. Out to Sousa. He's going to look to cross it back in. He does. Finds Patino to Gil. Yes. Gil. That's Gil's first goal of the season. That's taken a little while. And he's got one now. It was a very clever ball from Patino. I thought he was going for the volley. It's my time. But he tricked us. He tricked all of us. Shit don't add up. Even on my worst day, down on my luck. I got the sauce, I'ma always come up. I tried it your way. Another equalize straight away. I trust me. I'ma go get these millions. Hope to hoping to you always had me waiting. And I'm about fresh out of patience. This time we switching positions. Now you under my submission. Like my rules. Big moves. Y'all heavy on trying to do a bloody shout. But the game situation keeps changing, and I'm not game to pull the trigger. Man, you got to do better there, buddy. Good work, Panicardis. Getting a bit jammed up there in midfield. Spread out, let's create some space for yourselves. That's it. Keep in possession, which is what we want. Pass has come very deep, sprays it out, looking for Werner, finds him. No one's in the middle though. Back to Gil. Bursts in. He's going wide. Pass is tired. He's not getting his goal today. With your tangled hair, hiding behind the curtains of your own despair. No one found you. Got some fresh legs on. No one tried to. If only they knew you held the golden light. If only they saw the anguish in your eyes. Minutes, last couple of changes. Werner come off. Horak, come on, and that's gonna have to do it. Okay. Oh, just go with the header. Deportivo. That'll be interesting. Well, we kicked off this one, Galactic. Here in Australia. I live in Australia. So we started with Adelaide United in the A-League. Goal of the save is to win the European Champions League. So we've been from Australia to South Korea to Italy to Germany and now in England. So I've gone all the way across a couple of continents to get here. It's been fun. Except at the moment, things aren't super duper fun. It's been very hard going. We're incredibly inconsistent, but on the upside, we did just beat Leeds. Finally. So how you going in Deportivo? Hopefully, conquering and laying waste to all that dare stand before you. 10 times in the lead, back to person. Not bad. Very good effort. So what have we done? We won the Australian A-League, we won the Australian version of the FA Cup, we won everything in South Korea. So K-League 2, K-League 1, Korean FA Cup and the Asian Champions League. We've won the Europa Conference League with Arminia Bielefeld in Germany. We didn't win anything in Italy. And we finished second in the Prem last season, but we didn't pick up any trophies. So we're still in the FA Cup because it's only just started. We're in the fourth round of that. This game against PSG that's next will determine whether or not we have to play qualifiers out of the group stage in Champions League. But yeah, there's a lot of season left, so I should probably stress less than what I have been. But yeah, it's been a worry. I don't really want to rotate for PSG. But I feel like Hosh needs to not start a game. Or is it just a complete forward that's not working for him? Should we play him deeper maybe? No, he can't play as a false nine. Put him back to advance forward. Palace beat Arsenal. Where did Palace come from? Like, how is that a thing? I don't think they've been out of the top four this season. It's madness. Why are we signing this guy? I can't use him. Yeah, he's been playing well, but he's been playing well in Mexico. Cancel transfer. Playing the third division. Yeah, the lower league saves are the best. We all know it. We all know it. I don't know how to get a good game out of these guys. We need three more wins on the bounce. So I can hold another team talk and say, well done everybody, you're great. Fix the dynamics issue. Because it is not good right now. I didn't want to go to tactics, I want to go to training calendar. I want to tweak this. Focus on the defensive shape. Whoa. We didn't lose to Leeds. Been a while since we've been able to say that. Midfielder, I don't need a midfielder. Him either. I mean, these guys have some good players. That seems unfair. The first in France. How are we doing? couple of bad results, we can fall out of this top seven, which will not be good. Again, we finished second last season, and there were times we were like 10 points behind the leaders. So maybe we're just on for another late surge. A good run of form, you never know what's going to happen, but this, they are convinced to get me to play Felix Wolf on the left wing. It's not happening, guys. Place is former club. Oh, that's right, you were here on loan and I couldn't get you back when we arrived. I remember that was a thing that happened 3 seasons ago. Here's some of your Carini. Some I don't need. Need English players. Like you can't score a goal. Fine, let's do the meeting. Suggestions. Was it like me playing? Where was he? England. Loan with no wages. I like it. The winger. In Germany. Not worth my time.
It's raining, I'm shining, still storming. Ain't loved it, feel so foreign. I ain't coming for me. It's raining, I'm shining, still storming.
Do 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 do. It's pain.
Something to lose, huh?
48 million, he's 26, is winger. attacking me is
pay hella dues, huh?
Central mid.
Options, what must to choose from? I'm on the hill, they say I could fall off. I'm going still, like who should I call on?
So I got some beers and people. Right. Show other recommended players.
Off the ears and still it don't solve none. I know the weather probably don't meet your schedule. You having sunny days, I'm picking up all the extra. But on occasion,
in the meeting, that was pointless. First game of the first league. Have you given me this? Yes, fingers crossed. Good luck against Espanyol. I managed Espanyol in FM21. Wasn't here on Twitch, which is my own save because I wasn't streaming then. And I took Espanyol to their first ever La Liga title. Fun as hell. They were like my sixth club in that save. It went for ages. Expecting a draw against PSG. I guess a draw would be okay. I don't know if it does enough for us though. We had a playing team of the week. Patino! How are we doing for fitness? Ox has got a better average rating. Sergio Biker. Do we start Biker? He's still not fully fit. Yeah, we're not going to chance it. How are we doing for money? Still not great. It's entirely possible we're doing a squad rebuild in the summer. Or we're gonna look to move on. Go to West Brom Championship, Saint-Étienne, in Ligue 1. We're not moving to France. We're staying in England, but we want to see what happens with these other clubs. We've been here three seasons. I think we've earned the right to put in some applications for a bigger club like United, Liverpool, Arsenal, City. We're going to take a quick breather because I'm going to go to the bathroom. And when we come back, we'll play PSG to hopefully get a win and avoid having to go through this stupid playoff thingies. I'm going to change the music too because I'm really not happy with this playlist. There's a lot of like very, very sweary hip hop going on. Anyway, all right, we'll be back in a couple of minutes. And until then, sit tight, don't go anywhere. I know if you do, we shan't be long.
I gave my heart to a stranger. Father, forgive me for it, but I don't want it back. If this pain is what it means to have it, then I'd rather be. Gave away my heart to a stranger. If time was bendable, why the years go by so slow, as if it wants to remember. Thank you.
Hey, listen up, I've tried to tell you this 100 times. Not getting better by lying there, pretending to cry. You on repeat, you can't see shit cause you have closed your eyes. You say you listen, but you're missing what it's all about. That's just another sign. Not growing up, you're growing old. Your life keep passing by.
That. Mostly that. Alright, we're gonna go play PSG. That is a thing which is happening. None of that needs to happen. Team selection, happy with that. Let's go. Okay. Anyone else up on the bench? Only I can come out. And that will do. Submit team. That's fine. That's all the bodies we can have. It's basically a must-win game. Otherwise, we're going to have to go through qualification playoff for the next stage, and we're not seeded. Slightly different team. Well, for Haas, he hasn't scored for a little bit, which is a worry. Playing a diamond, the cheeky little buggers. Look at that. Alright, here we go. We are away from home too, so. It's a very slim possibility a draw is enough, but. Probably not. I got a free kick. Get to the area. It's perhaps not going as planned. Totally struggling against the first strikers. Yes. I know the feeling. Our defenders struggle against everything. There is no point getting stuck in against these guys. Turn at 8. We need a goal. We're not getting enough of the ball. Team talk time. Straight down the middle of the road. We're going to go positive. We're going to chance it. Scores the 86th minute. Yeah, they'll do that. Oh, passes in. But wide. Bailey's been terrible. Exhausted. I'll try Wolf. Why the hell not? Zeus is spent. Everybody's dead. Pass for the free kick. Ooh. It was on target. I didn't really see where that went until the... Oh, he's hit the crossbar. No, or has the keeper got a hand to that? Unsure. Attacking and more direct. No, not like this. I knew it was a risk to go attacking, and we've been punished for it. God damn it. Inconsistent. I don't even have the words. These guys are so annoying. I can't even talk. And now we've got to play the stupid qualifiers. The last thing we need is to have to play more football. No one's getting a day off. I'm sick of Santillana. Second match, Louise again. Nice. But this guy, Santillana, we brought him in. I paid a freaking fortune for him. 80 million. He's averaging a 6.79. He's having one of the worst seasons of his career, and he's just been awful. And I'm done with him. I've criticized his performance. He's cracked it. So I've just transfer listed him. Because I've had a gutful. Congratulations, Wolf, you're a new starting left back. Because I am sick of this crap. Oh, Offer him a week's wages, get that money back in the bank because he hasn't earned it. No one's going to come in and pay for him or make an offer. No one has. No one's going to want him. This is crap. Second worst signing of the save, Santignana. Easily. Just when he was getting back into form. Go find yourself a new club, mate. I'm done with you. Been here 6 months and I already want you out the freaking door. Haaland retired. No, Haaland's still going, believe it or not. I don't think he's announced yet, but City aren't doing great. Erling Haaland, there he is. Still scoring goals. Ridiculous. But yeah, still there, still knocking around the place. He's got no pace anymore. 307 goals for Manchester City in 496 appearances. It's not bad, is it? Fix his team. Oh, I've got an idea. I've got an idea. Of course, been lighting it up, playing for the kids. Imagine if I could swap Santignana for Ambrosino. Not gonna happen. Young midfielder in, he can give us some cover at defensive mid. He's not super awesome, but also he qualifies as English for squad registration. Aha. And he's not costing us a penny. So I like it. Still winning games of football. It's baffling me. So the last thing we need is those guys flying high while we're really struggling. Performance out of these clowns. The defense doesn't work at all. Morale's still quite good despite being transfer listed and cracking the sads. That's hilarious to me. We need to add something to this team. We've got no money. I don't care if the defense is weak. Let's bring in another striker. We'll play with two up top. I'm just going bonkers now, desperately trying to make a signing because we're just going to close. We brought in one player, goodness sake. We've sent a bunch out on loan. But we're just not getting any traction whatsoever.
just keeps turning, and here I am still learning about what it is that you need, what it is you bleed for, longing and yearning, deeply burning for you. Are you staying with me? Help me feed it.
Song you out for volume. Two more days. Okay. I think I'm happy with how that's set up. Will it work? Probably not. We'll find out in a minute. I'm not playing Hawks right now. Need some competition for Hosh because he's gone off the boil and I've got no one I can depend on to step up and make a difference. Osborne showing week after week he can't start a game. Every time we tried it, it's been an abject failure. He's gonna play in the cup game, but we did put a lot of pressure on that kid to be the like backup slash apprentice striker to Hosh. He won the Golden Boot last season. He's not going to do it this season because he's got nothing. Imagine only 7th place. We are so far off the pace now. In two players this window, a free loan and an ancient centre back that we don't actually want to use. Bailey, supposedly they won't put in a bid, not for 100 odd million. There's no way. If they do, I'll bite their arm off. I'll buy Pollard for 77 million. Kind of big. Who's that song we've got? Let's go! Take our medicine against Crystal Palace. He did beat us earlier in the season. We're coming off the back of a bad beat against PSG. Let's just get it done. Are we at home? We are at home. Having shots, but we're not seeing any highlights. Corner, Sousa. Wolf heads over. And Palace have got the ball. There's that guy with the headband again. He was causing us trouble last time. Oh, God! Sousa with another corner to the near post. Posh was in, but Springs has popped up and scored a goal on the rebound. We are 1-0 up against Palace. This is where it begins, everybody. This is where we turn it around. See, I don't know, we'll probably concede. You know, I'm super positive lately. That's why everyone's tuning in. The last 3-4 streams have been a nightmare, and I apologize for my negativity, but you've all seen what's happened. I'm never gonna mess around. I'm gonna praise it. We're 1-0 up. It's a miracle. We're winning a football game in the league, in the first half, no less. Concentrate and don't do anything dumb. Curtis has done well, plays it over to Springs in the goal scorer. Bailey turns, launches it for Sousa. He's got support in the centre. Passes look for Haas, and Haas just tapped it in. It's the worst goal you have ever seen, but it bloody counts, and he hasn't scored in what feels like a donkey's age, so I'm giving him a toot on the trumpet for that one. What a run from Sousa. He just exploded. And Hodge didn't actually get to that ball from Sousa. The defenders touched it. And Hodge just tapped it in before the goalkeeper could recover it. But hey, it counts. Oh, not like this. Pogden didn't even move there. Praise the lads, I don't even care what happened to you. We're 2-0 up before half time. This is unheard of. Oh, make that three. Petrosko has popped up with a third. Three goals in the first half. We haven't done this since we smashed Everton 7-1. Oh, my goodness. We're winning a game. I don't even know what to say. It's the same problem, but opposites. Let's go. More of that, gentlemen. Haas just steals the ball and runs and runs and runs. Shoots from a million yards out with no power or accuracy whatsoever. And that's fine. You can do that for the next 40 minutes, mate. Fill your boots. We're gonna make a couple of changes at the 60 minute mark. Purely fitness reasons. Vicott's going to come on for Gil. Trosco's got a yellow. No, they're complacent. If you're complacent, you're not getting a run. I'm going to sub Sousa. Even though he deserves a goal.
Still
place. Let's go. Here we go. But it's tired, so here come on for him. Tired, so stop him straight away. That's it. That's our lot. We're done. Ready to talk, baby. Can be your rock, baby. Please come and sit with me. Or take a walk with me. I need to speak to you. Just want to be with you. Just let me take you for a ride. Is there a chance that we could make another try? I think we meant to. So it appears damage was done in the first half, and everyone took their foot off the pedal a little bit. But that's a 3-0 win against Palace, and that shoots us up to 5th place. That looks much better, and I'm a much happier camper. Get to throw the praise around. You did well today. You did well. You did well. You did well. You did well. Look at all the green. Oh, we haven't had a performance like that in a while. Job, everyone. I don't have to find anybody. I don't have to talk to anybody for a poor performance. Oh. All right. I'm far less homicidal than I was half an hour ago. Unbelievable. Cecil was man of the match. He was superb. Good job. Pressure. No comment. Seven point something. His last game. Wow. He's got a real attitude problem. He did a good job.
Oh, you praised everybody, baby bear.
Shut your face, you freakazoid. Alright, we're going to finish off this transfer window and see if any offers come in for players, which will dictate whether or not we can buy anybody. But it's doubtful. I guess after his average performance, any interest Chelsea had in Bailey is going to be much, much cooled. Slash non-existent. In the FA Cup next, which I don't think we're going to play tonight because I've just realised it's almost 10 p.m. so we're going to finish off deadline day, see if we can actually purchase a player that might help us out. Yeah, and then I'm going to call it a night, kids. Pretty upstream, it's not bad for Sunday. I would have gone much earlier today, but again, I went out to the football last night and I just had a super lazy day. There's no point streaming if you're not super feeling it, because no one's going to have a good time. Not that it's been, you know, a joy to behold lately. And that's on me. Deadline day rumours. Zuna, Dienda, nope. Okay. deadlines out. Because it's super annoying. We just want to see if anyone makes an offer for any of our dudes in the first round. Offers have come in, probably all loan deals. He's a good player, that guy. Who's this guy? Oh, he's a striker, it would have been great. So, yeah, you can go to Derby. Game Player of the Month, good job. Second in Manager of the Month, didn't win it. Boo. Dane Colgan, one of our loanees. League One Player of the Month, good stuff. Can't offer him out. And that interest is gone now. Is going to be fit. Interesting. Just filling with the squad for the Cardiff game and avoiding hitting continue. We're not going to buy anybody. We don't have any money. It's horrible. Belly. Hey, welcome champ, how's the stream going? We're close to wrapping up. This is how we went. And I've been super negative all stream, thinking everything is horrible, but we only lost two games. So, meh. But the loss against Everton was ridiculous, given that we smashed them 7-1 up here. So, you know, that was dumb. And the loss against PSG meant we've got to play the stupid Champions League qualifiers. And that was after, you know, two wins on the bounce. So we can't... We're incapable of stringing wins together in any way, shape or form at the moment. But it was actually much better. And we just beat Crystal Palace, who were much higher on the table than we were at the time. So we now find ourselves in the following situation. We are... God damn it, we're back to seventh. Well, that's annoying. We were up here in fifth, but we're back down in seventh. We've got to play these stupid playoffs against all these clowns. We'll probably draw someone horrible like Barcelona or Chelsea or PSG again or something dumb. And it was like the 87th minute that we lost to PSG too. 1-0. Ugh. Santillana is one of the worst signings we've ever made. The defence isn't working at all. Hoss isn't scoring goals like we expect him to. So it's been a bit of a hard slog. Yeah, I hate this Champions League format. It sucks. But it's not even like SI's fault. That's the way it's going. That's what how they're going to do it. And it's ridiculous. Oh, you joined the Discord. Well done. Commiserations. All of that coupled with the fact we're going through the transfer window, all we've got is 19 million in the kitty, and we can't buy anyone for that money. We can buy this guy, a young left back, who's no good to us, because we won't be able to register them for any competitions, because we need him to be English. This kid, 21, he's not very good at football. And again, the transfer fees are just getting ridiculously out of hand. Like, who's buying that guy for nearly 300 million? Nobody, that's who. It's available for loan, but he's not good enough. He's not going to be competition for Hosh the way we need him to be. There's just no, there's nothing we can afford. Still going. We are nowhere near winning a Champions League at this point. Another free signing. Absolutely. I'll bring in another player for Bupkis. Hell yeah. That's all we've done in this window. We've bought a centre back for 325 grand from Brentford or Bournemouth. He's 32 and rubbish because we sold Yasser Asprilla. So we needed another body to make up the 8 players trained in England. We've brought in this loanee, Ernesto Favre, just to make up numbers. We've got a cap for Argentina though. He's on loan from City. It's costing us absolutely nothing. We need to get him a bit of game time though, because he could help us out. In fact, yeah. Kill the rest. Defensive midfield on support. Okay. Beautiful. And this guy, Alfred Donington, he's cup tied. What a shame. He was never going to play in this match anyway. But he's an experienced centre-back, he's useless, he's never going to play for us. And it's a one-year contract, so no biggie. Regen faces, skins, but I hate the SI new gen faces, they're horrible, they were better 10, 15 years ago. I did use Zealand's face pack. In my FM21 save, that had nothing to do with Twitch, it was just me playing for Poops and Diggles. We've been seeded for the draw. Let's watch the draw. Go. Speed, much faster. Start the draw. Go, go, go. So I'll just let this run while we're doing our thing. Hey, Flashtastic. Thanks for the follow. Much obliged. Yeah, so Zealand's face pack. I was using it, and then it was a like very early version, so I couldn't messed it up a couple of times, like reloading everybody, so the faces kept changing. And it wasn't until like way later I figured out there's a way to do it without replacing all the ones you already had and blah blah blah. We've already been drawn out of the hat, which is why I skipped ahead. We've drawn a Bayer Leverkusen in our qualifier, who we've got previous with from our time in Germany with Arminia Bielefeld. Let's have a quick goosey at them and see how they've got. I believe we bought a player from them. Let's bring his name. Jerry Norris. We had him at Arminia Bielefeld, so that rings a bell. Anybody else? Sahel Goy. Striker slash right winger we had at Arminia Bielefeld is there, knocking around the place. That's not the Novakovic we had, that's a different dude. Yeah, so that was about it. But okay, a couple of familiar faces they have. But no one incredibly scary, so that's fine. Ugh. In my face with it. That's a good idea using the AI. That's a good shout. But yeah, Dylan's one was cool. It was very fiddly, from what I remember. But I mean, obviously, anything is 1,000,000% better than this. Like, there's got to be a better way for them to do this. And they used to do it. Again, the new gens from like old school FM were 1,000,000% more lifelike. How anybody is looking at this in 2023 at SI and going, yep, nailed it. Baffling. Brings God to life. Yeah, that's the thing. Like, we're at the point where pretty much everybody is a new gen, but like if Hosh had a real face, be way more attached. And I think that's why I've got such a soft spot for the players I had in my FM21 save, because of that Zeal and face pack. So my all-time favorite FM player, Angelo, had one of the AI-generated faces, and that's what I picture in my head when I think about that save. Or the Argentinian midfielders I had, the Brazilian right back that I had, it was awesome. Yeah, like it's all about the immersion. It makes a huge difference. And that's where I think like SI and Miles and Co, like, they do an amazing job with this game, but there's bits of it that they're missing, and I think they're missing some of the key points of this game. Like, they keep tweaking the match engine and everything else, and that's cool, but things like the data hub, this does nothing for me at all. It's boring, it's fiddly, it's a hassle to use. This stuff, I know they tweak it every now and then, but there's nothing to do here. You can have a team meeting, you can change your code of conduct. That's it. You can't modify the hierarchy. You can't influence your social groups other than through mentoring. You can't, like, you can sort of directly address some of this stuff, but not always. The medical center. What do you want me to do with that? Risk assessment. Players who play heaps are a higher risk of injury. No joke. Like, it's information, but it doesn't do anything. Point is, what they're missing is you spend way more time on this screen, checking this screen and here, than anywhere else, and maybe here. That's it. Focus on that stuff, and bear in mind, and this is my point, they've forgotten what the game is, or they don't actually realize what the game is. This isn't a football management simulation at all. It's not, because managing a football club is nothing like Football Manager. This is a role-playing game. It's just there's no plot. You create it in your head. It's theater of the mind. That's why saves like this, Wizard of Oz, work. That's why Lelujo's content, like his non-league to legend every year, which is basically Wizard of Oz. That's why it works. That's why people get invested in this stuff, because you attach to the players and you attach to the club. And you attach to the story that you're creating. Manager timeline is not the right implementation, but that's the sort of stuff they should be doing. And I agree with Dr. Benji. Manager timeline would get way more attention and be way more valuable if you can add your own stuff to the manager timeline. Things that you care about, that you want to remember. When it comes up at the end of the season, I don't read it all. I scroll straight through it because most of it's friggin' irrelevant. Nobody remembers the 6 potential wonder kids I signed at Adelaide United other than Aaron Basich and Iren Kunda, because they're the 2 that I liked that I talked about all the time. The ones that never made it, nobody cares. So why does it retain that? It shouldn't. It should let me pick. I'd rather have Aaron Kunda, Aaron Bacic, NDIE, the defensive midfielder we had, the goalkeeper that we brought in, who I think, can't remember what his name is, the Baron Akea, the dude we bought from Juve's second team. He was awesome. I want to remember that guy. And I do. The game doesn't. The game doesn't rate him. But FM's a role-playing game, and that's the angle they should take. Whether it's... Here's an idea. A base idea. And your FM traditionalists would friggin' hate it. And I totally understand. But when you're going through your career, instead of these arbitrarily going up, give it, make us complete coaching courses. Give us a 10, 20 question quiz that we've got to do to get a coaching badge. Make us complete training units to learn about football and how it works. Like, make us train to be a manager in some way, just a mini game or something like that. It doesn't have to be based on like proper training courses, but something along those lines. And then when you get your badge, let us pick where we invest our skill points. Have a skill tree. We're allowed to do it at the start of the save. Because you know what? I would rather have more adaptability than what I do. I've managed in 5 countries in this save. I've gone from Australia, South Korea, Italy, Germany, and now England, but I've got an adaptability of 1. According to the save, I speak 4 languages, but I've got an adaptability of 1. All of the best players we've had in the save have been under 23 for the most part, but I'm better at disciplining players than I am at working with youngsters, and that doesn't hold water for me. Let us do that stuff. Make this stuff matter. The relationships with players. I don't remember interacting with Ufuk Tale from the A-League at all, but there he is. I've never had another interaction with most of these people since the first season, but they're on that list. It doesn't matter. But do you know who should be on there? Posh. My favourite striker of the save, Lee Ing-Yu, the best striker we ever had. He should be there. Why would I lose my knowledge of South Korea and Italy? I should have at least an understanding of what goes on there. This is the stuff I'm saying. This is a role-playing game. It's just not marketed that way. And it should be. They try to do it. Do it your way. You're the star, you're the gaffer, blah, 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 blah. But they don't back it up with features. They're developing the wrong stuff. You've got no relationship with your staff at all. Again, team meetings are along the right lines, but it's the wrong implementation. Less clicky-clicky, more conversational, more interaction, more immersion. I hate the word, because it's overused and it's got negative connotations in the gaming community. But that's my hot take. And of course, a set piece creator. Not that I'd ever use it because I'm lazy, but that stuff. So yeah, there you go. Let me just hop down off my soapbox. Oh, I feel better for getting that off my chest. So now I've made an idiot of myself ranting, raving about FM. Stop doing the game from FM about 20 years ago and the way the game has evolved. Yeah, FM hasn't evolved. Preaching. Yeah, I know. It's embarrassing. The game's not that different to what it was back in the championship manager days. At the core, it's exactly the friggin' same. 3D match engine, yep. Interface, bit different. It's tidier, bit sleeker. But I think the old guard be a significant change. You will never, ever, ever get a full-blown FIFA-style 3D match engine in this game. because Miles and Kay are terrified that if they do that and up the graphical requirement, Football Manager, they'll lose money and most of their players won't come back. What they're missing is the people on the SI forums, which is where they get all their community interaction from, mind you. They still focus on the friggin' forum that's been there for 20 plus years. They're worried that that's the majority, and they're not. I don't go to the SI forums. Most FM content creators don't. And they're the ones out there marketing the game. Not the dudes who are still sitting in mum's basement after 30 years playing this game, pissing and moaning that they've had to upgrade their graphics card for the first time in 15 years because of the 3D match engine. Those are the people you don't need. They're going to buy it regardless, and they will upgrade their machine to play it because it means that much to them. You're not reaching a new audience at this point. Yep, exactly. Exactly. It's a big problem. The industry and the technology has evolved past what they're willing to do and what they're willing to risk. Yep. I don't agree with everything like Zeeland, Alujo, Benji, Second Yellow Card, all those guys. Not all of their ideas, but they don't agree with each other either. There's nothing wrong with that. And I'm not at all suggesting I'm on their level. But in an apparent ideas vacuum, all ideas are valid. The big change for FM23 was, look, we got a Champions League license, we've got a UEFA license. It didn't make a lick of difference to anybody's game experience. You might watch a draw animation once on this channel, and I still killed it as soon as our team were drawn because it's freaking boring and useless. Like, it doesn't matter. The match engine enhancements are great, but it doesn't have a visual engine to back it up. It's still not 100%. I still have no idea, for the most part, why Delibasic has had all his red cards over the last 18 months in the save, other than his crazy slide tackle. Because you can't see it. Yeah, exactly. We are fans of the worst looking game on the planet. Is this the guy I was looking at before? He's 23. Is he any good? Sorry, I'm just getting distracted by shinies. 6.25. I'm gonna put in a bid. Might not be enough time to complete a move. Plenty of time. It's 9:15. Mate, to me, sign a contract. Yeah. Offer accepted. Southampton have already got him. That sucks. They should change that too. I should have been able to sign that guy. But yeah, Candy Crush looks better than FM Match Engine. And that's not just my graphics card, because I'm running a rubbish computer here. I'm running two of them, and they're both crap and ancient. Old i5 processors, NVIDIA 1030, doesn't even have a fan, it's passive cooled. It's a crap rig, but it runs FM. And that's literally what they want. That's how they want it to go. That a machine this poor can run the game. And it shouldn't be that way. They need to be brave. The fact that they released this game on PS5 and Xbox is laughable. Because console gamers aren't playing this. You put this next to FIFA, you put it next to any other football game, and it can't compete. And Flash is right. It's really, really hard to explain this to people who've never played it. Yeah, but that's the thing. SI are a small company. You'd need two separate dev teams for that. And they won't spend the money because they don't have the money to spend. You don't even need that. I don't think you need two versions. I think you just upgrade the match engine, the graphic engine, and set the requirements for what they need to be. And people will upgrade. They will absolutely do it. I'd do it. I'd go out and buy a new PC if this can't run it. Everybody would. Simple as that. And they won't lose. They think they're going to lose all the goodwill they've built over the years if they do that and offend people and upset longtime fans and lose money. You won't. They've earned that goodwill by not doing it for 30 years. Upgrade the game. Make it so people can't play it on a friggin' 386 running Windows 3.1 anymore. And you know what? All you've got to say is, you've had 20 years to get up to speed. Like, the money you saved by not having to upgrade your computer for this long, now you'll need to do it. And don't apologize for it. You're delivering a better product. Don't apologize for it. And don't be afraid of it. Because if FM keeps having update cycles like it did for FM23, if they go through the announcement phase for FM24 and addition out news, and it's anything like it has been for the last 3 years, i.e. really underwhelming, that's how you're going to lose players. Because if FM24 is no good, people just won't get the next version. And people do it now. And they'll lose a lot of exposure. Like, Dr. Benji and co were talking about not creating FM content anymore because there'll be no point after the FM23 announcement. They were so disappointed and so jaded, and there was so much negativity around it. It was hard to get excited. And I was just starting out, and I was like, great, the whole FM community is going to die as soon as I get the nards to jump in. And as someone who enjoys streaming and making content, I won't sit on FM23. I'll buy FM24 no matter what it is. But, you know, I hope for all our sakes, it's a much improved product. I've saved the game. I'm going to save it again. I don't want to mess around with squad registration and all that. But thank you for the chat, lads. I am going to bounce. Because it's 10:21 PM, I want to watch a couple of episodes of what the hell did I go back to watching? Parks and Rec, which I haven't watched for like 12 months. I finished all of Brooklyn Nine-Nine again, so I'm doing a run through Parks and Rec for my late night viewing. So I'm going to do that. But thank you, One Cup Champ and Flashtastic, for, you know, let me get all that off my chest. Feel free to clip it, share it around, my hot takes that are now almost 9 months old that everybody's heard before. Brilliant stuff. We will be back tomorrow night to do all this crap, do the squad registration, and we're going to try and get through all of these games. We did that tonight. We're through those games. It's pretty good. But we've got Champions League survival on the line, FA Cup survival on the line, and huge games against Bournemouth, Tottenham and Norwich. It's going to be fun as hell. Up to South Africa. Oh, South Africa. All right. We might have to do a save over there then for Flashtastic. At some point. Next season, next year, Wizard of Oz. We'll see if we can get to Africa. We didn't get there this year. And I'm not leaving England now. But that's very cool. Thanks for swinging by. That's awesome. Reaching out to the whole world. Yeah, tomorrow night, we'll be back here in the DP Dome. I'll do a proper intro because I couldn't be bothered tonight. Normal service will resume. Yeah, until next time, I shall see you next time. I'm going to press the right key. Here we go. You ready? Here we go. Bye-bye. Bye.